A lot going on this week. I'm gonna bring you guys along for the ride, but the vlogs are back. Can't wait to show you what we've been up to. Let's go.
Hey YouTube, what's going on? Just wanted to do a quick video as a life update. A lot has happened. I know I haven't been on YouTube as much as I wanted to be, but that's because I've been busy. When it comes to real estate professionally this year, it's been a bumpy road. Now it hasn't been a bad year, it's been a tough year, but not necessarily a bad year. We've learned a lot, we've grown the team. And if you follow me on social media, on Instagram, you saw that I moved the MS group from Compass to the agency, which has been an amazing, amazing move. Honestly, nothing wrong with Compass. It's a great brokerage. Have nothing bad to say about them. I actually think that their technology is way ahead of any other brokerage. They're simply just killing it when it comes to technology. But I thought it was time for a move. It was time for a change. The agency opened up a new office here in La Jolla, and not necessarily just because of that I wanted to move, but I thought, you know, the agency has a more boutique feel to the brokerage itself, which is something that I missed before Compass. If you've been following my story before Compass, I was at a brokerage called Canner Brokerage, and it was just a local San Diego brokerage that was a really boutique brokerage, and I really just like that, you know, feel of just smaller and being different than everyone else. And so when I moved to Compass, it was great, it was amazing. I grew my business, I started my team, but now, you know, I kind of miss that, you know, boutique feel. So we decided to go over to the agency. Now, if you're not familiar with the agency, it's a brokerage that started in 2012 by a guy named Mauricio Umansky. You've probably heard of him if you're in the real estate world, or if you've seen Housewives of Beverly Hills. He is one of the husbands on the show. So he started this brokerage back in 2012 with Billy Rose, and they've really grown it a lot. Most recently, they started a show on, or they filmed a show on Netflix called Buying Beverly Hills, which is an amazing, amazing show. If you haven't seen it, I invite you to go on Netflix and look it up. Here's a shot. You only got
one life. Give it all you got. I think you got it.
Yes. Woo-hoo!
You honestly understood the assignment perfectly.
Do you not know the history behind this house?
This is the infamous murder house.
Now you tell me.
Yeah. Do you know what kind of stone this is?
Kakara, Kolkata, Kolkata.
The consequences in the business world are a lot different than the consequences at school.
No chance this house sells below $6.5 million.
That's not gonna be good enough.
Like, now knowing that grade, I'm gonna be so scared to do a bad job.
The more successful you are, the more they'll talk about you.
She feels very betrayed. Okay, so I'm in deep then.
This is gonna get real Jerry Maguire right now. Who's coming with me?
Am I being recruited right now?
Fierro's put a lot of work into Joey. Mm-hmm. I was told that you had been poaching Joey and asking him to work for your team.
I have a really tough question to ask you. Do you think real estate is the right business for you?
From all the real estate shows out there, you know, you have Selling Sunset, you have Million Dollar Listing, of course, all these, you know, flip shows on Netflix and HGTV. I started watching the show before joining the agency, and I honestly, honestly believe, and I tell this to my wife every time we were watching the show, I'm like, this is the most realistic real estate show I've seen. Yes, there is drama, obviously, because drama sells. Just take a look at Selling Sunset. It's all drama. It's like 90% drama, 10% real estate. With Buying Beverly Hills, it's really down to, like, I almost want to say like 85% real estate and 15% drama. But it's an amazing show. If you're a new agent out there or looking to get into real estate, it really shows you how difficult this business is. And this business is really, really hard, especially, you know, the year that we've had right now in 2023. It was a bumpy road. We had interest rate hikes. We had this whole NAR lawsuit that happened. If you're not familiar with the NAR lawsuit that's currently ongoing, there's a class action lawsuit against NAR with commissions as far as on the selling side. Typically, a seller pays the cooperating broker who's representing the buyer a commission. Now, this whole thing started with a sale that happened, I want to say, in Minnesota, for Missouri, for $400,000. The agents negotiated a purchase price of $390,000, so $10,000 less. Now, when the deal closed, the seller thought, hey, why am I paying the buyer's agent to negotiate against me? So they thought, topic or an interesting lawsuit, because he thought they were agents were colluding and antitrust laws and so on and so on. I mean, it's just in a nutshell. Anyways, it kind of snowballed from there, and it's become a massive lawsuit that I honestly think it will change real estate moving forward. And we are expecting more and more lawsuits against big brokerage to happen. I mean, just in it in itself, but this is a really tough business. And I think because of that, you know, the people who pull through, the people who succeed, are the ones who are passionate about real estate, which is me and the team. Everyone on the team, I think, really, really enjoys being an agent. Being an agent is not easy, because, well, we were commission-based employees, I guess. We're 1099 employees. We're self-starters. We're kind of, if you want to see it, entrepreneurs. But having said that, you know, I still love it. I still wake up every morning, can't wait to get to work, can't wait to do these videos for you guys. And so that's kind of what we've been up to. You know, we grew the team. When I was at Compass, it was me, Joya, and Naveed. We transferred over just from one day to the next. It was like, hey, guys, I had a phone call with them. It was like, hey, guys, we're moving to the agency. And I said, if you guys want to come along with me, then, you know, I promise you, I'll take care of you, and we'll make the transition easily and smoothly. And they said, wherever you go, we'll go. So I really, you know, that meant a lot to me. And so when we started at the agency, or when we moved, you know, it's just a different vibe. It's just a different culture that the agency has that I hadn't felt it anywhere else. And so little by little, as time went on, you know, I had more agents reach out, more agents wanted to join the team. Right now we are at 8 agents on the MS group. And, you know, I get asked all the time, like, hey, are you looking to grow the team a lot more? Yes, but no, not really. I really want the right people to join the MS group. Young, hungry agents who realize how difficult this job is and still want to take on, you know, the day-to-day operations of a real estate agent. Because what you see, again, in the shows is nice, is like exotic and these amazing properties, and you know, you get to drive around these awesome cars and have lunches in our random Monday, and it's nothing like that. I'm in the office right now, and I'm doing these videos, I'm making phone calls, I'm door knocking, I'm flyer dropping, I'm doing open houses, I'm cleaning homes for showing so the home looks amazing. So there's more to it than what you see on TV. But having said that, you know, that's kind of a little bit of a life update. Everyone at the agency has been awesome, and our office is there on La Jolla. Again, can't complain with the location. We're right in, you know, we have an ocean view from our office. But I decided to branch out a little bit and rent this office space here in San Diego so I could do more videos like this, you know, with the lights, with everything, the whole setting, and have this for the team. And so again, a lot of changes this year. I've really been more active as far as social media goes on Instagram. If you follow me on Instagram, you've seen my stories and my daily posts. And there's been a lot going on in real estate this year, from interest rates to home values to no inventory. We have really, really low inventory, at least here in San Diego. And we expect that to change moving forward. We expecting interest rates to drop in 2024. Again, if you are a buyer out there, interest rates dropping means you have more buying power, but you also have more competition on the buying side. If you're a seller, then awesome. Home values will go up. They're slowly, you know, there was a correction in 2023 and home values did drop a little bit. Not as much as people thought. But if interest rates come down, then home values will go up. Now, if you're a home seller, keep in mind that, hey, where are you going to next? Are you going to buy next or are you going to go rent? Rents keep, you know, trickling up. But if you're going to buy next, then keep in mind that, you know, interest rates, more competition. So it's kind of one or the other. But yeah, we are expecting a great 2024. Little bit of a life update that I just wanted to shoot this video, jump on here and just talk to you guys. I'm sorry I haven't been on YouTube. I do expect to be on YouTube way more in 2024. I think I say this every December, but I'm gonna hold myself accountable to doing at least 1-2 videos a month, 3 videos if possible, you know, between family, the team, you know, the business. It gets really, really busy. Now I have 2 kids and schools and, you know, which is awesome. I love everything about it. And I kind of did put the vlogs and everything on the back burner, but I promise you, I'm gonna bring back the vlogs. They're coming in January. I already recorded the first one. Still editing it, actually recorded the first 2 vlogs. So they're going to be coming out really soon. I'm still editing those. I'm really, really excited, about that as well. And now we have this space. So that means I could talk to you guys a lot more and do these talking head videos a lot more and really fill you in on what the market is doing as far as San Diego goes. And I do want to incorporate more vlogs. Why? Because I have so much fun filming them and editing them. I think this is one of my favorite parts as being an agent is the marketing side. And I really do consider an agent in 2024 to be a marketer first and an agent second. Now, this doesn't mean that we don't study the market. We read about the market every single day. We have team meetings twice a week. We have office meetings once a week at the agency. So obviously there's a lot that's, you know, constantly happening. Now, when it comes to real estate, you know, it doesn't happen overnight. It's a slow burn. And so we see things ahead of time, but moving forward, like I said, I'm gonna do more of these videos for you guys. I promise you, a lot has happened in 2023, but I think nothing but the best will happen in 2024. I am really looking forward to 2024, both personally, personal growth, financial growth, and professional growth as far as the team goes. By the way, the team, if you're looking to join a real estate team, reach out to me. I'm more than happy to either talk to you, see if the MS group is a right fit, or I could even point you in the right direction. I know a lot of agents out there. Most of the top agents in San Diego, I know, or at least I could point you in the right direction. So if that's the case, reach out to me. You're in San Diego, reach out. And if you haven't subscribe, hit the like button to get more videos just like this one. I'm gonna revamp the whole YouTube. Just watch. We're gonna have a lot of fun in 2024. So look forward to seeing you guys more in 2024. Can't wait. Peace.